Good morning. I'd like you to meet my friend, Ted E. Bear. Can you see him? Yes, he's a Bairdsley. He usually lives upstairs, but right now he's in a place called timeout. So I'm going to turn him a little bit so he feels like he's in timeout. He came down and got into my blueberry stash, and he has his own blueberries, so he knows he has to be here just for a few minutes, not very long. He's going to think about things and maybe make a new plan. It's fun to pretend, isn't it? But in our Bible lesson today in Deuteronomy that Pastor Cindy's going to be sharing soon, the time out is not pretend for God's people. It's real. And our Bible lesson reminds me of a time out for God's people. They were in a place called the wilderness. Now, if you remember, they had been in Egypt. They'd come through the Red Sea experience, and they were out on the other side. And I think some of them thought they were ready for the new land. But God said, nope, I want you to be in a time out. I want you to be in the wilderness for a while. What is the wilderness? Well, the first four letters of wilderness are wild, W-I-L-D. We could even say the wilderness. And what is a wilderness? Well, it's dry. It's sandy. It's desolate. That means not a lot is there. It's barren. It's untamed. It's a desert. And I have here, if you can see, some sand. You all have some sand probably in your sand table or sandbox. It's very dry. You wouldn't want to, you can't really grow crops in sand too well. And also, because not much grows, the things that might grow are very prickly. Maybe some scrubby kind of bushes. So it's a dry, barren place. Well, why were they there? Why were God's people in this wilderness, in this wilderness? Well, first of all, God had their attention when they were there, for sure. He met their needs. The people saw God meeting their needs for water, for food, in the form of quail and manna. And he was testing them, maybe to know what was in their hearts. He wanted them to follow him in the hard times. He was forming them into a people who would trust him and walk in his ways. He was preparing for them a new land and new victories. If they felt lonely, he wanted them to know him as friend. If they were worried, he wanted them to know him as peace. If they were weak, he wanted to be their strength. Will they follow him? Well, sometimes they did, sometimes they didn't. But when they did, they were very, very blessed. Right now, it's sort of like we're in a timeout place, isn't it? With the pandemic, will we trust God to bring us out, to be with us? Let me read a verse from God shared in Deuteronomy a little bit later in the book. It's God says, be strong and courageous. Don't be afraid. Don't panic. The Lord your God will personally go ahead of you. He will neither fail you nor abandon you. He won't leave us, and he doesn't want us to leave him when we go through timeout wilderness experiences. So be strong. Talk to him. Trust him. Now I guess it's time for Teddy Bear to come out of timeout. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.